Hello everybody, welcome to another episode of Things to Do with Stu. And today we're going to be making a propeller powered, elastic band powered plane. So here's one I made earlier in true Blue Peter fashion. So this is what the plane is going to look like. If I show you like that, you can see that here's my propeller here and my elastic band that I wind round. This is what gives it the power. Okay. Here's my wings. If I show you the underside, that's what the underside is going to look like, okay? So it's quite involved. To do this craft, you're going to need some cardboard. You're going to need a couple of straws. You're going to need three big skewers or something equivalent, three big sticks or something like that. You're going to need one cocktail stick, small one, or something equivalent, an elastic band, a paper clip, an old biro that you don't mind cutting up, and a bottle, okay? Masking tape or sellotape, scissors, pen, pencil, and maybe even a ruler, okay? Let me show you this one in flight first. Check this out. Okay, pretty cool, right? So we're going to start the build, and we're going to start with the body. Okay, which is this cardboard section here. So to start with the body, you need a piece of cardboard and you also need a pen. And you need to get the pen first, because from your biro, you're going to need the center section like this. And you're preferably going to need it empty, because we're going to be cutting it up to use this. You'll need to get this first, because you need to make sure that the piece of cardboard you pick, okay, is not too thick, because this part of the pen we're going to be fitting into the gap, into the corrugated gap there in the end of the cardboard. It sounds complicated, but if you get a bit of cardboard that's really thick, then the tube here will move around too much. And if you get a bit of cardboard that's too small, you won't be able to slot the tube in. When we cut it up, it's going to be really small like this. If I show you here, you can see that, I'll turn it around here. In the end of the cardboard, perhaps you can see, is the pen. And so it's really important that you pick a piece of cardboard that you can get the end of, or part of the tubing into. And when you selected your cardboard, it's also important that when you come to cut out this shape, which I'll give you the measurements for in a minute, you need to make sure that the corrugated bit here goes up and down, not side to side, okay? So this is the sort of shape you need to measure. Now this is 12 centimeters high, it's 6 centimeters wide at the top, and it's 2 centimeters wide at the bottom. Okay, so that's 12 up and down, 6 at the top, and 2 at the bottom with a gap in the middle. It's important that's done quite neatly, because this will form the main part of the plane. If I show you here on the one I've already built, it's this shape here that we're going to be making. So once you've cut that out and you've got this shape, the next thing we need to do is the propeller. Okay, so the propeller is this shape. It starts off at this shape, another piece of cardboard. This is 4.5 centimeters wide and 2.5 centimeters high. Can you see the sort of shape that is? That's 4.5 centimeters wide, 2.5 centimeters high, like this. Okay, now here's where it starts to get a little bit more involved. To do the propeller, we're going to do the actual propeller fins first, which is when we're going to use our plastic bottle for. So you can see on this one, I've drawn two propeller shapes on my plastic bottle. And if I measure these for you now, they are about 9 centimeters long. But you can play around with the size of your propellers, but I've done ones that are about 9 centimeters long. Once you've drawn them on your bottle, you need to very carefully cut them out. If you're not sure how to do that, get a grown-up to help you. I'm going to do that bit right now. Using my scissors. So, I've cut them out roughly. Now I'm going to neaten them up. Okay, so here's my two propellers. Okay, you can see they're slightly curved, which is going to work really well for us when we come to fly the plane, because of the curvature of the bottle. So, these two parts are going to fit onto this central section here. And the way we're going to do that is really simple. Okay, using our scissors, we're going to cut a line into this side here, about a centimeter, like that. And we're going to do the same on the other side, like that, about a centimeter. So I've got flaps on each side, and I'm going to do the same on the bottom of each propeller. I'm going to cut a line about a centimeter right in the middle there, so you can see that. And I'm going to do the same on the other side, like that. Can you see that? I'm not sure how well that shows. Then we just need to slot these in together, so they slot into one another. Make sure one of your propellers turns one way and the other one, with the curvature of the bottle, faces the other way. Okay. So you should end up with that when they slot in together. Then we need to get some masking tape or some sellotape and just wrap round each side just to secure it. I'm going to do that now. Okay, there we go, there's my propeller, and you can see on the one I made earlier, it looks the same. There you go, two propellers like that. Right, now we're going to assemble the propeller to the main body. This is the fiddly bit. We are going to need the biro. So you need to take your biro, the inner tube of your biro, which hopefully you already know fits into the cardboard that you've picked, and we need to cut a bit of biro that fits in to the 2.5 centimeters at the top of your propeller. Okay, so I've got a bit that I've already cut here, and now I'm going to poke this down the center of this piece of cardboard. It's a bit fiddly, so have a bit of patience when you're doing it. I'm going to do that now. Okay, so I've now put the end of my biro, the tube, down the center of the piece of cardboard. That's the first piece. Now we need to do the same, put a smaller tube piece of inner biro in this top section here, this part here, like this. I'm going to do that now. Top tip, you can always use a cocktail stick just to widen the gap slightly if it's a bit tight. Okay, so I don't know how well you'll be able to see that, but in the end there is a bit of biro. Okay, right. So that's the really tricky bit. There's one more tricky bit, is to take your paper clip, to straighten your paper clip out as straight as you can. This one isn't terribly straight, but as straight as you can. And we need to feed the paper clip down through the top of the propeller. I'm going to do that now. Right, so you can see my paper clip goes all the way through. And I've left a bit at the bottom and a bit at the top. Now you need to push it all the way down, and at the end you need to curl round your paper clip. You can use a pair of scissors to help bend it, because this is going to push all the way down and then clip on to the end of your propeller. If you look at my hands, I've used a biro that's still got ink in it. If you look at this one here, you can see that at the end, the paper clip, I don't know how clear that is, the paper clip catches on to the end of the propeller there to keep it in place. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so I've bent it round. I've done it quite big so you can see. You'll need to do it smaller than that, but I've bent it round, and that just holds the paper clip in place. Now the next thing we need to do, before we attach this piece to this piece is to create a little washer, a plastic washer, just to stop the two bits rubbing together. It's really simple. Take your bottle again, cut just a random square out of your bottle, like this. Oh look, I've got an imprint in the middle of it. And then you'll need to put a little hole in the middle of your bottle. Maybe use a knife or something sharp that you've got, or a pair of scissors. Get an adult to help you, and then cut round it to create a circle, like this. Can you see that? It's really small with a small hole in the middle. That's my washer. That, once you've got that, then goes onto your paperclip at the bottom. Like that. Can you see that? And then this section goes through the pen that you've already put in the top of your body. Like that. Can you see it sticking through? The next thing to do is to bend this side, this paperclip round, to create another hook where the elastic band will catch. That's this bit here in the middle. This bit here. Can you see that? I'm going to do that now. If you're finding a pair of scissors difficult, you could get a small pair of pliers and you can bend it round. So once you've got your paperclip bent round, leave that bit, that top bit now is finished. We're going to make the underside. It might look quite complicated, this bit's actually really simple. The first thing we need to do is to take two straws, like this, and cut about 2 centimetres down at the top, but don't throw any of the bits away, you need those bits. Okay, so the two shorter bits, we're gonna stick at the top like this. Can you see? I've got 2 shorter bits here, then a gap, and then the long length, 2 shorter bits here, then a gap. The straws are gonna be what we poke the cocktail sticks through. So I'm gonna stick them on now. So it looks like that. And then we're gonna take the 2 longer bits and leaving a gap, I'm gonna stick them at the bottom, lined up with the 2 bits I've just put on. So I'm going to do that bit now. Okay. So can you see there? You should have that kind of a shape. Don't worry if it feels a bit flimsy, it will soon get a lot stronger. What we're going to do next is take our small cocktail stick and we're going to stick it through the side of the cardboard and out the other side. About that high up there. Be very careful as you do this, you don't want to prick your fingers. I'm going to do that now. So it goes all the way through. Take your elastic band, take the cocktail stick back out halfway, pop your elastic band through, and then push the cocktail stick back through so the elastic band sticks on like that. Okay? Next, we take our big cocktail sticks. Now, if you're using ones with points on the end, cut the point off the top because they're dangerous. We don't need that. Just use a pair of scissors. 1. There's 2. And the cocktail sticks are going to poke through the straws that you've just stuck down, and then we're gonna use masking tape to stick the cocktail sticks in. If I show you this one, so the reason we've left the gap here is so that we can stick the cocktail stick directly to the cardboard, and then we're gonna wrap the cocktail stick round together at the other end. So I'm gonna do that bit now. Okay, hopefully you can see that. So I've stuck the masking tape at the bottom, holding this cocktail sticks together, and I've lined them up at the top. So now this makes this body section much more rigid. Okay, we're nearly there, we're getting there. Now you need to take your final big cocktail stick, cut off the sharp bit, the point, we don't need that. Okay, It's just going to act as the tail on the plane. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start my cocktail stick up on the piece of cardboard just below my cut line, and I'm going to tape it all the way down like that. So I'm going to do that bit now. Okay, there you have it. So there's the main body of our propeller elastic band power plane. Next is the wings. The wings are dead easy. So for the wings, for the large wing, an A3 piece of paper. So we're doing this top wing here first. Okay, it's very simple. You need to fold it in half. You need to get another straw. And we're gonna place the straw just above the center, and it's gonna go all the way along in the middle of the plane. So it's best if you use your ruler to mark and find the middle of your piece of paper, then mark and find the middle of the straw and line them up. I'm just gonna grab a straw and I'm gonna do that. So you can see, if I put it in red, the two red lines there are the middle of the straw and the middle of the paper, so it's in the middle. Then I need to just fold the paper over the straw, and tape up the open ends like that. And then the wing tapes across and just tapes onto the plane. So I'm gonna put mine on about there. If I show you the one I've already done, I just use the masking tape to tape it on. So I'm gonna do that now. And again, you want to get it in the middle of the plane where you had your line, so it's weighted, the weight distributes evenly. That's really important when you come to fly. So there we go, there's my wing. So we've got the propeller at the front, we've got the elastic band that's hanging loose at the moment, we've got the rear wing. Now for the small wing at the back, need another piece of paper, and we're gonna use the width. So I'm gonna cut about 3 centimeters all the way down. I'm gonna do that now. If you do that a little more neatly than I've just done it. Now you can either fold in each half and have a single sheet of paper, or cut one that's 6 centimeters and fold over like we did for the main wing. I suggest that you test it out and see what works for you. You need to get another straw. Find the center of the bit of paper and stick the straw on the bottom, just like we did for the main wing. I'm gonna cut this straw in half. It doesn't need to be quite as long. Okay, so there you have it. And then that sticks on the bottom as well, just like the other one did. And there you have it. Like that. If I show you the one I've already done, so there's the main wing there. This one, the rear wing on this one, I folded over. So this was a 6 centimeter piece of paper that I folded in half. That probably makes it just a little bit more rigid. And that gives you your plane. So the next thing to do is to take the elastic band, it's already attached at the bottom of your cocktail stick, simply hook it over your paper clip at the top, and then wind it round and round and round, and that will create the tension in order to make the plane fly. So if I show you on this one, you can see that the elastic band goes round the hook at the top, then by winding it round and round and round, the elastic band gets tauter, tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. You'll have to experiment with how tight you can go. And then by letting it go, it should spin freely. If you find it's getting caught as it's spinning, you might need to just cut the corners. You can see that on the propeller, we cut the corners on the cardboard piece, just so it doesn't catch on the main piece of the cardboard. And then you need to wind it up, throw it and launch it and you'll see your propeller will carry it and take it, just like I showed you at the start. So there it is, your very own elastic band powered, propeller powered plane. Try it yourself. Have a go. Boom.